a surgeon got in trouble because he would sign his initials on the surgery livers. He would take a liver out, put a new one in, and before closing the person up, write his initials SB for Simon Bramhall. He's 53, a little too old for this nonsense. He got found guilty in the UK on two counts of assault by beating. They said that usually these signatures disappear, but this one did not on one of the people, and she had to have additional surgery. This is so crazy. Thoughts, five words or less.
Well, we found the zodiac.
X marks the patient's liver.
Grossest God complex ever.
I can't believe even.
Okay.
It was so bad.
Slow clap. Almost slow clap.
No, yeah. It was so bad.
But
that's one of those where you're like, I don't know, like a kamikaze pilot. It's like too late, but has second thoughts at the end. It's like, I'm gonna pull up. And then you just hit the top of the target. And it's like not even an effective kamikaze run. Because it was so bad.
But there will be someone in the comment section that was totally here for it, Brett. Mm-hmm.
So bad. Anyways, can we talk about anything else besides my terrible five words or less? This guy, so he goes in and he laser surgeries his initials. The thing for me is like there's people in the room.
They're complicit.
Yeah. Well, he's doing it. Yeah. What the crap?
Because, okay, right? So my mom does surgery, right? They do cleft palates. This is a true story.
Oh my God.
Well, because your question was.
Cool mom.
Yeah, it's really cool stuff. I asked for a nose job and her doctor wouldn't do it for me for free. I was like, screw you. But, because we're friends, I know you. But these surgeons, I think, and I could be wrong, but you know, there's a God complex that's associated with some doctors sometimes. They feel like they're saving a life. They're literally saving a life. They're handling this vital organ. So why not mark my territory, if you will? I think it's gross though, because it is. They're saying it's beating or it's an assault on the person's
right,
body.
Right, and that's just like the code for it, you know, or you're not the legal code is it's assault by beating, it's not assault with intent to kill or whatever the other
and
terms
then
are.
You don't want to infuriate the doctor because the doctor, you realize that when you're part of a team helping to save someone's life, you have to be a helping hand mentally for the doctor to make sure that things go smoothly because of insensitivity or whatever.
Right.
So it's kind of like these people are complicit because one, they probably don't want to lose their job. Yeah. Which is not an excuse, but that's probably why they didn't say anything.
But I mean, couldn't they even like go to HR and be like, hey, there's a problem, there's, you know,
slide into HR's DMs.
Minor problem here, you know, this guy's yeah. signing
really great
livers.
Really great to work with, nice guy, parks in the right parking spot, you know,
not a problem. Yeah, but
does sign livers though with laser pens.
This is like how I would imagine it playing out, kind of going off of what you were saying, yeah. Aaron, in the sense of like, hey, what's the guy's name again, Robert?
Simon.
Simon, close. I was like, hey, Simon, like, What you doing there? Oh, I'm just writing my initials. Cool. I don't think you should do that. I'm gonna do it. Okay, cool. End of surgery, taking off gloves. Hey, Stacy from HR, we gotta talk right the fuck now.
Immediately.
Yeah. And like ending that there.
Right. That and the logical people would have done that, and you know, but they said that there was no damage to the liver after being cauterized.
So typically what happens is like, oh, the liver's pretty resilient.
And they regenerative.
Yeah, and it'll like heal itself. But this one woman didn't, and she had to go for an additional surgery because of it. And they're like, what the fuck?
Yeah, it's all fun and signatures, so someone gets hurt.
Okay, question, and I don't know anything about science or medicine. Is it possible that because livers are so regenerative that he was testing it and like, you know, like, oh, I'm gonna give a test to see, make sure everything's good.
He's a fucking doctor. He knows that already.
You mean the laser test. You mean the laser test. Oh, you mean the tagging test, the graffiti test?
Yeah, like is it possible that there could be
liver
an actual
spots.
Benefit or like a testing?
Possibly, that's a true. Sure.
No!
Okay.
No, Grace,
no.
Maybe someone
question.
In the comment section would be wondering,
exactly.
And thank God Grace asked.
I do know about liver surgery a little bit. And what I know is from my friends who are doctors who are like, it is the most batshit crazy surgery, the one where the most stuff is like taken out and placed here mm-hmm. and taken. It's like that and like a C-section, which is crazy. But they're just like, you have to pull organs out and move
stuff
them.
Over.
And we're putting a liver in there, and the liver's enormous, so you need to put it in, and they put in a certain amount of a liver is like the minimum amount that then can regenerate. But no, Grace, afterwards they run tests to be like, how's your count of whatever cholesterol, I don't know what the liver filters, impurities. Is it filtering right?
I will say though.
That's like saying, if the liver is a giant filter, right? That's like saying we replaced your pool filter, and to make sure that it's filtering right, we've all taken shits in your pool. Just to make sure that it's working out okay.
Brett, so Grace, that's not a dumb question to ask though, for sure.
Thank you.
It's not dumb. It was very funny. Thank you for it. I was so brave of her to ask that question.
You were very nurturing.
She's trying to make
it. Very brave.
Sorry, I took advantage of it.
It was one of those like,
I'm very brave.
I had two back surgeries with the same doctor, same neurosurgeon, Jesus. And he told me after the second surgery, he said the way I stitched you up in the back is a signature of mine. So by him telling me that, these people have these massive egos, mm-hmm. that this is they attack a body, if not attack, but like they approach, I'm sorry, a body.
But they would say something. They would say they attack it like a problem.
They don't attack bodies. I'm joking. But they approach.
They just start punching
you in the back. I'm on the table like this. Wow. But they approach a body with a game plan, right? So after they have succeeded,
they play Scrabble.
No, never mind.
After they've succeeded,
they close up, and so they want to. It's an accomplishment for them to do what they do, right? So maybe. Him signing his name was him saying, I saved this person's life, and let me just.
Oh, like, boom. I nailed it. You're welcome.
Crushed it.
Simon.
Right, and
I'll back you up on that.
Yeah,
I know,
what I'm saying?
Doctors who are like, surgeons are the worst. They come in, they think they own it, they know everything, and then they tell everyone else. They feel like other people aren't real doctors. Mm-hmm. Oh, you're a pediatrician.
Oh, you're a nurse.
Have fun putting a Band-Aid on that.
Yeah.
I'm gonna put a new heart in someone.
Yes, uh-huh. And look at the documentary about Dr. Strange.
This would be.
He had an ego.
Wow.
But okay, yes, Grace, to your point, but this whole scenario would be a great episode of Grey's Anatomy. Like, Meredith gets busted.
By Meredith carving her name into someone's liver?
Remember
on
that?
Accident. Not like her character.
Or Amelia who had the brain tumor was like, I wrote like a sonnet on someone's liver. I don't know what happened. Where was I? I don't know.
I was so emotional. The dreamy dumped me and I just
Winter
wrote an
finale.
Entire poem on a liver.
You want to know the weirdest thing I've heard from a surgeon? He was a. He said that when he does surgery and he's using the laser cutter to do stuff, it smells like seared meat.
Well,
I mean, it is. That's essentially what it is.
So we were cooking. He's my roommate. He's like, that smells like. It smells like surgery. It's weird, but like I always think of it works.
No,
In-N-Out burger. It was so awkward.
Delicious. I love In-N-Out. I've been wanting it for the next few days. So I'm gonna get it on the way home today. Thank you, Jason. Don't go away. We have one more story when we come back. It's about a groundbreaking new culinary invention that will make you wanna puke. Don't go away.